we have a new airplane. And it's July 4th. Anniversary coming up this week. Next week. Whatever week it is. July 4th, 1908. Glenn Curtis won the Scientific American Trophy for the first flight of 1 kilometer or more. That was right up in Hammondport. In 1909. Well, demonstrates the control system. 4.5 on the steering wheel actuates the elevators, which are on the front and rear outriggers of the airplane. Turning the wheel like your car operates the rudder on the rear of the airplane. And then Glenn Curtis, the motorcycle racing, knew that you lean into the turns on a motorcycle when you're racing it. So he incorporated that into his airplane. A shoulder harness, you lean in the seat. You want to turn left, you lean to the left. You want to turn right, you lean to the right. Right. A lot of body English flying the 1911 Curtis Model D Pusher. One of the most famous pilots in this airplane, Lincoln Beachy, who set all sorts of records, plunged over Niagara Falls in a Curtis Pusher, into the mist, down below the falls, and came zooming back up the Canadian side. World famous flight in a Curtis Pusher. This airplane was also the first type to fly off of the deck of a ship, and later on, they set up for a landing platform. On the main landing here, this airplane was seen three little hooks attached to it, and they did it just like they do today. They had ropes stretched across the deck, tied to sandbags. Tail comes up. Bundy there.